For those of you who play God of War and or watched a bunch of Chinese action flicks, you guys will feel extremely familiar with Heavenly Sword for the PlayStation 3. Some of you will probably even accuse this game of being a God of War ripoff, and though I would kinda disagree with you, your remarks wouldn't be illogical. If God of War was made into an intense movie, with the platforming and puzzle segments taken out, and replaced instead with the female protagonist and arena-style combat mechanics, you'd get this game, Heavenly Sword. Actually, you know what? It's hard for me to kinda consider this as a game. It's more like a movie. I mean, yeah, you do play the game, but once you come to realize that playing the game is actually kind of repetitive, at least this is from my perspective. I know a lot of people really love playing the game, but to me, it just was repetitive and boring. So, for me, it was more like a great popcorn movie, but not really a great video game. The game contains three gameplay elements, and really only three. 1. Combat with hordes and hordes of enemy crowds in arenas. 2. Controlling projectiles in slow motion with the 6-axis motion controller. And 3. Boss battles. That's pretty much the entire game. There's no platforming, there are no real puzzles. All you do is fight, 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 run to the next huge arena filled with enemies and fight, 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 and fight some more. After you're done with the fighting, you'll be asked to control some projectile firing weapon like a cannon or a bow and arrow, and begin a time limit to eliminate certain targets. Within that certain time limit, you shoot the cannon and control the projectiles in slow motion with this tilt sensor. After that, you come to a more arena-style area and fight more enemies. Then you may come to a cutscene, and after fighting more enemies, you'll come across a really unique boss, which will you most likely be required to beat at least 3 times. If such a game design doesn't scream repetition, I don't know what the fuck does. The thing is, I admit the combat mechanics are unique, and it's actually cool how players must perfect their timing with different stances in order to block and counter different moves. And it can actually be challenging at times too. I love the combat system, kind of, you know? If it didn't repeat itself so much, but I didn't have to do it so many times, do the same thing so many times, I would have really liked it, because changing stance, you know, the light attack stance, the heavy attack stance, the guard stance, it's a really cool concept. I found it pretty innovative as a combat mechanic. But by the 3rd hour of the game, and that's barely half the game now, it becomes repetitive. So, to me, it was just too easy for me to conclude this, just a really boring game. But then again, I don't want to hate this game, simply because the game's production value is phenomenal. The voice acting is amazing, the graphics are gorgeous, just gorgeous, and requires no load times whatsoever unless you die and must respawn back to a level. The characters are all unique, and story is presented in such a way that you really feel like you just paid $9 to watch a really good quality action movie, promising themes of courage, duty, myth, death, and all those cool things. And the premise behind this whole story is just so cool. The Heavenly Sword, Nariko, but the character, the relationship she has with her sister Kip, which is actually a stepsister, the villain of the game, the voice actor for the villain, and the facial animations, absolutely incredible and engrossing. So just for the production of the value, I really find it hard to hate the game. But in all honesty, because I didn't like playing the game, for me, I think it would have been better just as a movie. I feel like if I was able to watch the whole thing, that would have been great. But then again, because I did like the boss battles a lot, especially the last boss battle and the one of the guys' name is like General Fox or something. The Fox boss battle. Some of the boss battles are just really awesome. It just sucks that you have to kind of beat them 3 times over. So there's repetition in boss battles, but boss battles are great. Most of the game, I could pass off without having played it. The game's story and the storytelling and presentation, phenomenal. Just for the amount of effort they put into all of that is why I pretty much bought Heavy Rain. That for that reason, I feel satisfied with it. But as a game, it's really not a game I would be replaying over again.